if you do this, get prepared to be rejected by the vendor. They most likely are not going to go into the further conversations with you. Hey, Andre here from Glorium Technologies, discussing the common mistakes that people do when outsourcing their software development. And in this video specifically, I'm going to talk about the requirements discussion at the time of selecting your future software development outsourcing vendor. The biggest mistake here is that people do not properly discuss the requirements, do not go into the level deep enough in order for your future vendor to produce a good quality estimate. You don't believe how many times I heard actually people coming and asking, what is the, give me the estimate on the Uber, on the clone of Uber or clone of Airbnb, whatever it is. If you do this, get prepared to be rejected by the vendor. They most likely are not going to go into the further conversations with you, because it shows that you're not involved in the product development. So whenever you, the action item here is whenever you get into the discussions of the requirements, make sure that you discuss them on a deep enough level for them to produce a meaningful estimate based on your functional requirements. So make sure you have a series of conversations before you get into the contract, and watch for the results of those conversations. What you need to look at. Look at the reaction of the other side. The agreement with everything, simple nodding, silence from the other end means that they do not understand what you're talking about and cannot bring a value into your product development. Most likely you're going to be leading, they're going to be the following. So it's less of the value that you're going to get from them. It's a good sign. Another thing, it's a good sign if they will bring a business analyst into those conversations in order to discuss your requirements. It means that the vendor has a specialization in multiple roles, and meaning that their process is very well established and very well, well set up. You can count on a good quality of the development then. Another thing is this business analyst, as you go through the discussion, watch that you should be led by them in this discussion. So they should be asking you a series of questions, confirming some of the items, pointing out to problems, suggesting the solutions. So in general, they should be driving the conversation. And the last thing, analyze your final state after you go through the requirements, through whatever one or two meetings with them discussing the requirements. At the end, you should know more about your future solution. You should have more of the items uncovered for you, more of the unknowns becoming knowns, more of the gaps filled. So if you were able to receive at least some of the value during those discussions, it means that the vendor is able to take a leading position in the product development and will help you in the future. Okay, so that's all for today, and next time I'm going to talk about the common mistakes when analyzing the estimate from your future vendor. So stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.